So about a month and a half ago, when I talked about how Elizabeth Warren revealed that she has a plan to essentially cancel about half of all existing student loan debt, which exceeds $1.5 trillion overall, by the way, among 44 million Americans, my response was, one, this is a fantastic proposal, and two, Bernie, you've got to get on this. You've got to do this yourself, because this is a plan that will definitely draw in younger voters, and those voters may potentially jump ship and go to Warren if they're supporting Bernie Sanders, just because this is such a phenomenal plan. And guess what? Bernie Sanders heard our cries, and he listened. Because as Jillian Berman of MarketWatch reports, U.S. Senator Bernie Sanders is the latest Democratic presidential candidate to stake out a position on how to address college affordability and student debt, but he's not offering a lot of details yet. Our plan forgives massive amounts of student debt, Sanders of Vermont Independent told CNN's Dana Bash in an interview Sunday that touched on student debt cancellation. His statement was a response to Bash's question about how Sanders' plan on student debt stacks up against those of Senator Elizabeth Warren, a Massachusetts Democrat. Warren unveiled a plan in mid-April that would cancel up to $50,000 in student debt for most of the nation's 44 million borrowers. Sanders declined to offer more specifics on his plan for student loan forgiveness during the CNN interview. When pressed by Bash, he said, "Our plan will cancel a substantial amount of student debt and in some ways probably go further than Senator Warren's." He added later, "I don't have the plan in my pocket right now." Warren had said in a previous CNN interview that her proposal to wipe out $640 billion in student debt is bigger than Sanders and goes further than his. So it looks like he's currently in the process of drawing up a plan, and he's saying, my plan is going to go further than Elizabeth Warren's, and Elizabeth Warren is saying, actually, no, my plan goes further than his. Now, I don't know that she's even seen his plan. So this is what I said back when I was talking about Elizabeth Warren's plan. Since she didn't opt to cancel all student loan debt 100%, she is essentially saying, let's cancel about half of it. She left Bernie Sanders' room to kind of jump in and, I guess you could say, undercut her in a way and offer something that is better. And it seems like he's going to capitalize on that, even if she is saying, no, my plan goes further than his. But this is one of the benefits of having multiple progressives in the race. This spawns competition and policy innovation, and they're competing with each other to be more progressive. This is fantastic. Now, let me tell you why student loan debt cancellation is crucial to this conversation. Let's look at some stats here. So 69% of the class of 2018 took out student loans, and currently, student loan debt overall, as I alluded to earlier, totals $1.56 trillion. It affects 44.7 million Americans, and 11.5% of student loans are more than 90 days delinquent or in default. Now, the average monthly student loan payment is $393, and the median monthly student loan payment is $222. That is absolutely insane. Such a huge portion of your paycheck is going towards student loan debt that you may never pay off. Like, a lot of people assume this debt and they expect to never be able to pay it off. They expect to have this when they are senior citizens or potentially until they die. I know a lot of people like that. I'm assuming that I will never be able to pay off my student loan debt unless a plan like this goes through. So it's absolutely crucial. Now, the question is, why do we have this need? And, you know, there's always a lot of people that like to shit on millennials and say, well, you know, millennials are just whiners. I went to school, I took out student loans, but guess what? I paid it off. Well, there's a reason why it's more difficult for millennials to pay off their student loan debt in comparison with boomers. Because when you compare the cost of college now with the cost of college in the 80s and 90s, the difference, it's infuriating. So when you look at private nonprofit four-year institution costs, tuition in 1987 cost $15,000. Now, when you look at tuition for 2017 to 2018, that more than doubled, $34,740. This is for a private institution. Now, when you look at public four-year institutions, back in 1987 to 1988, that school year it cost $3,000. And going to 2017, 2018, it tripled. That is insane. So we can't keep going in this direction. With $1.5 trillion in debt, more than 44 million Americans burdened with student loan debt, you've got to do something. And all of these mealy-mouthed plans at like capping the payment at 10% of your income, that's not enough. You have to cancel it so people feel as if they actually are going to be able to pay it off. Now, if you're asking me, I'm saying, let's just cancel all of it. Let's give everyone a fresh start and then make public colleges and universities tuition free. So Bernie Sanders can potentially do that. It seems like his plan is still in the works, but nonetheless, the fact that he's considering this is exactly what I wanted. So the fact that him and Warren are competing to be the most progressive is important. However, with that being said, Elizabeth Warren is gaining a lot in the polls, and I like that, you know, she keeps proposing these plans because she's really forcing Bernie Sanders to step up. Now, I don't know why Bernie isn't able to influence her to step up on Medicare for All. I'm not saying that that's the fault of him, but it's certainly her pivoting away from any talk about Medicare for All. But nonetheless, this competition is important, but as Elizabeth Warren goes up in the polls, the prospect of progressives potentially splitting the vote is starting to really worry me. Now, here's one poll that kind of gave me pause. So this is from the Des Moines Register. Biden is at 24%. And then when you look at Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren, Bernie is at 16%. Warren is at 15%. Now, Buttigieg is at 14%, just behind Warren. And Harris is at 7%. Everyone else is pretty much polling between 0 and 2%. Now, assuming that if Elizabeth Warren or Bernie Sanders weren't in the race and that support would go to the other candidate, when you combine them, they're at 31%. They would be surpassing Joe Biden already. So I'm getting a little bit worried that progressives could split the vote. And this was one of my fears going into 2020. There's so many candidates running. So long as there's more corporate Democrats to split the vote than there are progressives, then hopefully we can consolidate our vote and push a progressive to the front. But now it seems like Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren are about even. Which, I mean, theoretically, it's nice to see, you know, progressives sitting at the top of a poll, but with that being said, I want to win, right? I want us to win. And this is assuming that, again, if, you know, Bernie was out or Warren was out, all of their supporters would go to the other progressive. You can't necessarily say that with certainty, but I mean, logically, you can deduce that they're cutting into each other's support. Now, remember, in order to get any pledged delegates, they're awarded proportionally, you have to get at least 15% of the vote in a primary in any given state. So what that means is that they're cutting into each other, and this really worries me because this could lead to a corporate Democrat winning. Maybe not necessarily Joe Biden, because it seems like his numbers are starting to dip, but potentially someone like Pete Buttigieg or Kamala Harris. They're better than Biden, but they're absolutely inferior to Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren. So at the end of the day, it's good that Bernie Sanders is proposing a student loan debt cancellation plan, and I'm glad that him and Warren are competing. With that being said, I really hope that they talk to each other about this and they stay in contact and realize that they both have the same goal, to defeat Joe Biden and defeat a corporate Democrat and get a progressive at the top of the ticket. Now, I really hope that's Bernie Sanders, because if it's Elizabeth Warren, I do worry about her electability. Certainly, she's giving us a lot with policy. She's producing policy after policy. She's running a pretty good campaign, with the exception of Medicare for All. But I think that Bernie Sanders just has more anti-establishment appeal, and he could really pick up voters that Donald Trump won over in the Rust Belt in 2016. So we'll see what happens. This is great. Love the innovation. Love the competition. But I really, really hope that we don't end up splitting votes and paving the way for a corporate Democrat. Rock.